Hello and welcome to the Jace Z stream. I'm your host, Sean Brayford. Today we're going to be playing some Modern Azorius Momo, or Monastery Mentor. The deck is built around this card, Monastery Mentor, which has prowess. It means whenever you cast a non-creature spell, it gets +1/+1 until end of turn. Also, whenever you cast a non-creature spell, put a 1/1 white monk creature token with prowess onto the battlefield. And we have a lot of cantrips like Serum Vision, Sleight of Hand. Serum Visions for 1 blue is a sorcery. Draw a card, then scry 2. Sleight of Hand, look at the top 2 cards of your library. Put one of them into your hand and the other in the bottom of your library. Path to Exile will also trigger a mentor. Supreme Verdict to clean things up in the early game in case things get out of control against aggressive decks. Then we have a package to protect the mentor. It's very vulnerable to lightning bolts, paths, etc. We have 3 Spellskite in the main, and then Lightning Greaves, which equipment, equip creature has haste and shroud. So this can come down on turn 2 and can equip the mentor on it on turn 3, assuming the mentor doesn't get killed before it gets equipped. A shroud is, it can't be the target of spells or abilities. Neither you cannot target it, nor your opponent. That's shroud. The difference between shroud and hexproof. Hexproof, your opponent cannot target it. Shroud, you cannot target your own creature. I'm gonna add more greaves, and then for a finisher, we have Sun Titan, which, handily enough, will also bring back a mentor if a mentor hit the yard. Or a Wall of Omens or a Kitchen Finks. So we have a few targets for it. We also have some counter spells. Sometimes you can also bring back Vendilion Click. Get a Snapcaster Mage just for value. A few Celestial Colonnades in the deck here. Or Ghost Quarter. That seems pretty aggressive. I'm going to take one of those out. I'm going to go down to 24 lands. And I think I'm going to add another. Sleight of Hand. For a sideboard, we have 2 Rest in Peace. One Revoke Existence, 1 Stony Silence for the Art of Affinity matchups, 3 Leyline of Sanctity for Burn and Thoughtseize decks, etc. 1 Grand Abolisher for the blue counterspell matchups. During your turn, your opponents can't cast spells or activate abilities of artifacts, creatures, or enchantment. Urkel's Recall for the artifacts affinity matchup. 1 Spell Snare for catching Tarmogoyfs, etc. Zoodex. 1 Teferi's Moat. It's a good way to lock your opponent out of the game. Excuse me. If they're primarily running one color of creatures that attack you. 1 Ratchet Bomb, good sweep up some tokens, and little 1/1 dudes floating around. Chalice of the Void, good against the burn, and the good on the play against Monastery Swift Spear decks and burn with catches lightning bolts and Monastery Swift Spears, etc. Relic of Progenitus, good to some graveyard hate in case your opponents run a bunch of Snapcasters, etc. Reanimator. All right, let's give this a whirl. Yeah, let's play first. Double colonnade. Ah, not great. I think we'll try this though. The Greaves, Roman, Wall of Omens. Some music going here. Opulent Palace, okay. Salt, we're up against Sultai of some sort. Snapcaster, pretty good draw. I think I like Greaves first, and then we equip Greaves when Wall of Omens comes down. Shivan Reef. Oh, four color. Interesting. Okay. It's an interesting deck here. Now we can Wall of Omens and equip with a Dispel Backup. We really want to protect the Omens, I guess. If he wants to fight over it, maybe we'll want to fight back. So. Of course, he could just counter the wall. Oh, okay. Here's a draw card. Serum Vision is nice. Well, I'm going to equip. Okay. And then I think here we just Serum Visions. Set up our next draw steps. Double Path. We'll keep one. We'll put one on the bottom, keep one on top. We don't know what we're up against yet. We drew a Dissipate off the Serum Vision. Exotic Orchard. Wow, okay. Maybe he's running five color control or something. I'm gonna save this Snapcaster. It could come in handy later. We really want to get our mentor online. We have Dispel Backup. Omden of Night's Reach. You have your upkeep, target opponent discards a card for each shrine you control. I don't like that. So let's just remand it here. He took his whole turn up, and we can dissipate in the next turn. And Verdict, just in case things go wrong. Cool. We have Dissipate up, Snapcaster, all kinds of goodies. Imagine that shrine will come down again, we'll dissipate it. We could Snapcaster Remand. I kind of like that, actually. Get some value. got a lot of value out of that remand. I've got an attacker. I think we equip the Greaves to the mate, to the Snapcaster now. Bolt in response. Let's dispel this. Yeah, dissipate up. We got spell. Let's leave dissipate up. We finally have a clock. That's good. And now we dissipate. Get five cards in hand. Pretty good. So we'll Spellskite here. Or do we activate Colonnade? Your whole turn. I think we run out Spellskite first. And it's not really protect. It can protect the Momo eventually when it comes. That's all we do here. Good double spell skate. I like holding one back in case we need a verdict eventually. A lot of counters, so you probably start hitting, landing some of these enchantments. Omden of Seeing Winds. At the beginning of your upkeep, draw a card for each shrine you control. You get to start drawing two cards. Okay. You and I buy star maps and drive my car around Los Angeles. Really need a mentor now. You and I buy, I think it's time to start activating Colonnade.